Ladies and gentlemen, John Stewart.
I am not a music critic, nor historian, nor archivist. I cannot tell you where Bruce Springsteen falls in the pantheon of the American songbook. I cannot illuminate the context of his work or its roots in the folk and oral history traditions of our great nation. But I am from New Jersey. And so I can tell you what I believe. And what I believe is this. I believe that Bob Dylan and James Brown had a baby. Yes. And they abandoned this child, as you can imagine, at the time, interracial same-sex relationships being what they were. They abandoned this child on the side of the road between the exit interchanges of 8A and 9 on the New Jersey Turnpike. That child is Bruce Springsteen. I didn't understand his music for a long time until I began to yearn. Until I began to question the things that I was making and doing in my own life. Until I realized that it wasn't just about the joyful parade on stage and the theatrics. It was about stories of lives that could be changed. I was working in a bar in New Jersey, as you would imagine, Central Jersey, right off Route 1. And every night when I closed the bar, I would get in my car, and I was driving, at the time, a 1976 off-brown Gremlin. The Gremlin was a car that was invented for two reasons. One, birth control for young males. And two, it was invented so that the Pinto wouldn't feel so bad about itself. But I would get in my car every night, and I'd put in the music of Bruce Springsteen, and everything changed. And I never again felt like a loser. When you listen to Bruce's music, you aren't a loser. You are a character in an epic poem about losers. But that is not the power of Bruce Springsteen. It is that whenever I see Bruce Springsteen do anything, he empties the tank every time. And the beautiful thing about this man is he empties that tank for his family. He empties that tank for his art. He empties that tank for his audience, and he empties it for his country. And we, on the receiving end of that beautiful gift, are ourselves rejuvenated, if not redeemed. And I thank you.
The songwriters who inspired me were searchers, he said, who spoke to our lives and our dreams. I searched for stories about the people I knew.
Screen door slams, Mary's dress waves.
In a small Jersey town, life was factory jobs, making ends meet.
The radio plays. Roy Orbison singing for the lonely. Hey, that's me and I want you only. Don't turn me home again. I just can't face myself alone again.
But he had a lot of heart and big dreams. And the one thing that he was sure of was rock and roll. Up and down the Jersey Shore, the little clubs went crazy for him. Word had gotten out. Something was happening.
One, two, three, go!
A Springsteen concert is like a carnival ride. It leaves you breathless and alive. Found himself at the center of the rock and roll universe. The Boss. But the bigger his success, the more he questioned. For the favorite son of rock and roll, growing as an artist meant taking on the bigger questions.
I come from down in the valley, where mister, when you're young, they bring you up to do.
He wanted his songs to bear witness to the hardships and heroism of everyday life. Try to meld my voice into the story I'm telling. And when a moment comes in our common history, I want to be there, he said.
May I feel your blood mix with mine? A dream of life comes to me. And like a catfish dancing on the end of my line.
Bruce doesn't just sing, he testifies. I'm in the middle of a long conversation with my audience, he said. It'll be a lifelong journey for both of us by the time we're done.
The Kennedy Center Honors will return with John Mellencamp, Melissa Etheridge, and Sting. The Kennedy Center Honors, sponsored by U.S. Trust, wealth management for today's wealth. Visit ustrust.com to learn more.